My name is Göktuğ Günkaya. I have made this work with Mevlüt Gürbüz and Aydın Doğan. My topic is electrophoretic deposition of tin dioxide nanoparticles in nanoaqueous medium for sensor applications. Our objective is to have a high surface area layer which can sense especially combustion gases and for gas sensing applications. My outline is first powder processing. For electrophoretic deposition, we have to have a stabilized suspension, and so we did this in this step. And after it, after having a stabilized suspension, we made electrophoretic deposition at different ranges, at different voltages, and also at different times. And then we had layers, we have depositions, and we have made some sintering experiments and also characterized the system deposits by SEM investigations. And also after this, we made a sensing characterization of the coating layer. This is primary result. I will share primary results of sensing in this presentation. When we talk about electrophoretic deposition, there must be a power source and there must be a cell. In the cell, there must be a stabilized suspension. We used tin dioxide nanoparticles, which has 60 nanometer diameter size. And we used this coating type from down to up. Why we did use this? Because to prevent agglomeration. If the agglomeration occurs in the system, when we use from down to up coating process, we minimize the agglomeration in the system. So, by the way, we have high surface area because, you know, for gas sensor applications, high surface area is a must, we may say. And here our platinum coated aluminum substrate is cathode, and here you may see our gold palladium electrode and tin dioxide nanocrystalline particles. And we have mentioned about this before. Cathode was up as here, and anode is down as here. We have seen it. And this vertical design serve advantages to prevent agglomerates. And the optimum range between cathode and anode layer was 1 centimeter is optimized in this study. And when we come to electrophoretic deposition process flow chart, first, as we said, we made stabilization, electrophoretic deposition, and like outline, we have seen this before. So I'm passing it, and now sedimentation test. Sedimentation is so important in electrophoretic deposition coating process because while the coating has been occurring, particles we have to prevent particles sedimentation, and by adding as medium acetyl acetone and tin dioxide, by using tin dioxide and acetyl acetone, we have reached a very good suspension. Also, first we add surfactant to it, iodine we have added, and by the way, we made a high surface charge particles, so we prevent sedimentation. But after this, for sensing applications, we need to make a sediment suspension which has no any surfactant. And so we prepared another suspension again with same particles, again in the same medium, but just with ultrasonification. And by the way, we prevented agglomeration, and we have reached a sediment prevention till to 15 hours. In this with surfactant, we have reached prevention of sedimentation till to 24 hours. But for electrophoretic deposition process, 10 or 15 minutes preventing of sedimentation is enough. And after this, we have to see our particles size. And before stabilization, we can see that three model particle size distribution here. And after after stabilization, you may see our particles that has 100 nanometers. Why they are 100 nanometers? We, at first, we used 60 nanometer particle size because of hydrodynamic diameter. Hydrodynamic diameter means our particles which has ion cloud around them. So this this system, dynamic light scattering system, measures both of them. So we see here our particles is 100 nanometer. And when we come to our electrophoretic deposition step, we have our stabile suspension. We have prepared this sensing layer. This substrate is made of aluminium oxide, and we have made this interdigital electrode from platinum. Why platinum? Because it is high conductive, and also it can resist to high temperature as alumina. And also we have made two sizes. This size is 25 millimeter to 25 millimeter, and this size is 12 millimeter to 12 millimeter. Also, the interdigital electrode is smaller than this area. And what is the also another advantage of the platinum layer? You may see here our platinum layer, which has a high surface area. And by the way, when we coat the layer by our stabile tin dioxide suspension, you may see here the platinum layer coated with tin dioxide, and this makes our sensor's sensitivity higher. And when we look to deposition time versus yield of deposition, as it is mentioned here, as the voltage of electrophoretic deposition increases, the yield increases. So, by the way, by this electrophoretic deposition system, we may we have a low cost process and a versatile process, and also by changing the deposition time, also deposition voltage or range, we may control the coating layer on platinum. So we may change, by the way, our sensor's sensitivity. And when we come to sintering experiments, we have used different thermal schedules. And first, here we may see unsintered version of our powders which are coated on the platinum substrate. And here we started sintering or thermal treatment from 300 degrees Celsius to 400 degrees Celsius, 500 degrees Celsius, and 600 degrees Celsius. Here we use the driving force of particles' surface energy. If the particles are smaller, the surface energy higher. So here you may see that particles bonding together. And why it is important in our study? It is important because we made a bonding at this temperature, and this makes the layer's mechanical strength better. And why we didn't use the sintering temperature as 600 degrees Celsius? At this temperature, particles started to grow. And when the particles grow, you know, the surface area decreases, so the sensor's sensitivity again decreases. And you may see all these images in the same slide here. And our preference was this. And after this, we have made sensing tests. We used LEL levels because, as you know, the 30, especially 30 LEL is important for gas sensing applications. And also, our another parameter was sensing. Our another parameter was our operation temperature. As it is seen here, when the operation temperature increases, our sensitivity increases, and you may see a great sensitivity at 450 degrees Celsius. But for an operation temperature, this is so high, and you may see also here for 250 degrees, 300 and 350 degrees Celsius sensing sensitivity values nearly same. Nearly the same, but as you see here, 250 degrees Celsius shows better sensitivity operation temperature than 300 degrees and 350 degrees Celsius. Also, there is another point here for 350 degrees Celsius operation temperature, we have a great sensitivity against the others, against the 300 and 350 at 60 LEL amount. And you may see that result from here. For example, when we use, when we try to use our sensor for 60 LEL combustible gases sensing, this temperature 250 degrees Celsius shows a very good result. Here we may see the 30 LEL experiments at different operation temperatures. At 400 degrees Celsius, you see the good sensitivity also. When we come to our conclusion, a low-cost system has been used by simple deposition suspension preparation. Also, stabilization has been achieved by this work, and electrophoretic deposition of tin dioxide to high surface area platinum coated layer made at 100 volts. And network structure or less curved surfaces can be coated by electrophoretic deposition process, low-cost process. And we have had high porous curved and raw structure, by the way. We have seen that 500 degrees Celsius is enough for bonding the layers together. And we may see at 400 degrees Celsius a high sensitivity. Also, this is an undergoing study. We will add dopants to see the gas sensing properties if we will have better. And we will make some other investigations for gas sensing characteristics. Also, we would like to acknowledge and we would like to thank to Anadolu University Research Foundation for supporting us. Also, for TÜBİTAK, also State Planning Office for support, and also our electrophoretic deposition setup is made by Onur Gencoğlu. We would like to thank to him, and thank you for listening to this presentation.